Richard, since I didn't bring my finger head up here, can you just put a little bit of reverb and delay, just a small bit for an ambiance?
Remember all the things we said.
shoes. Did I love you or did I use you? Did I hurt you or did I help? Did I hear you say that you had nothing to lose? Yeah, yeah, yeah. I used to hold you in the night. Dreams were your danger. I lay awake until the light came. My heart is still the same, dear. Could I knock on your door? My heart is still the same, dear. I would hold you anytime. Without you, life is stranger. Some things were wrong, but some were right. Yeah, I used to hold you. Someday night's gonna take me. Without you, life is stranger. Some things were wrong, but some were right. Yeah, I used to hold you. I used to hold you in the night. I used to hold you, baby, in the night. And then I realized I was booking a summer tour and didn't have my shit together and send you anything, so I hope I get to sometime.
Thank you.
thanks goes out to Laura, too, for being vulnerable and being willing to accept help from community, because that's not always easy to do. And I remember when I went through something with one of my family members, and this was a real haven for me to accept help from the community and support. And so thanks to this Joe and everybody at Saxon Pub for hosting us today. Woo! So I'm kind of torn. Do I have one song or two? One? Do you know? I think it's one. I don't want to make you late at all. So I just want to check real quick. Okay. Because I was trying to decide if I do a happy or a sad song, and I want to do something really uplifting. But then there's also this song that Richard always wants to hear, and I never play it. And he's running sound for everybody all day long. But it's a really sad song. So I'm going to let you decide, because I want to know what you need. Yeah, you want the sad? This one. Yeah. The song that Richard wants to hear.
Yes, that's what Richard wants to
hear. All right. Honey Tree Lord.
Richard knows his shit.
Super sad. Apologies in advance. There's a positive message in it. I wrote this song after I read a book called Amazing Grace by this guy Jonathan Kozol, and he was a teacher in Connecticut, and he was traveling to the South Bronx on a regular basis on a train to meet families in an area called St. Anne's. And so the story is about poverty and difference in socioeconomic classes and the invisibility of some people in our world. But the really beautiful part of the story, I mean, it's all beautiful, but the happy part is that there are all these children in the story, all the kids that go to school there that he started meeting, and the amazing amount of human spirit and positivity that they had despite their situation with their families. And I put that book together with the story that I loved when I was a little kid that gave me a lot of hope, which was Winnie the Pooh of all things.
No. But
I really connected with Christopher Robin because I lived as the firstborn of 34 future children and grandchildren and great-grandchildren. And I lived in a neighborhood where there were no kids to play with, so I played with my stuffed animals in the yard outside my hippie stepfather's music studio, which is how I ended up like this. Caught in a capsize of an ancient crime, the summer is sleeping, there's not enough heat to rise in the building. Oh, you wonder what I say when there is a place in the South Bronx we're going. Hey, it is a hell most of us have helped design. Christopher is waking, he's always sure to rise. The fairy tale is dying, the devil is home tonight in the building. Oh, the boy is an angel, he waits by his mother's side. He never is sure if she will make it through the night. Who would believe it? We're halfway to hell in the building, a prison for the poor. Satan doesn't go to work anymore. She is working, giving free needles to medicate theirs. All the suffering so many won't see, selling their goods by the honey tree. Don't you remember the childhood story, the bear and the boy and the tree full of honey, needing to share his sweet, sweet treasure? There was enough, enough to go around working for pennies. Too painful to mention, the suffering is stronger than a petty opinion. But won't you consider the opinion that you have enough? Oh, who would believe it? We're halfway to hell in the building, a prison for the poor. Satan doesn't go to church anymore, 'cause she is weeping, giving free needles to medicate theirs. All the suffering so many won't see, selling their goods by the honey tree. We're halfway to hell in the building where Christopher was born. His mother doesn't go to work anymore, 'cause she is dying before the free needles she medicated theirs. All the suffering, oh, and the boy, how will he believe in the lie anymore? How could he believe in the lie anymore? The honey tree lie anymore.
Thanks everybody for coming out. Supporting. Yes. Very nice, take care.